Okay, we're going to do another gameplay video. This time we're going to try this bounty over here where we help the DGSC find information on private military contractors in Yemen. Sounds exciting. In the last video we used Social Engineering Toolkit. Hopefully in this video we'll get to use something different. So I'm going to go ahead and accept it. My target is militic.net. I need to find the name of the recruiting officer. Now this might be good for us because
Turbine C2 registry initiated.
I already have access to Militech.net, but we're gonna do it from the very beginning just so you can see the various tools. Now this is called the DNS and VHost mapping tool, and this allows us to scan for subdomains on Militech.net. We'll do 30. Now, as you know, there are domains on the internet which are basically servers, and people can put up subdomains on there, which is basically servers within a server, I guess you could say. So what we're doing is we're looking for domains on Militech.net that we can hack into, subdomains that we can try and hack into. Now, we don't know the names of any of those servers yet. So this tool is going to do what's called dictionary attack, where it's going to try a bunch of different common names for subdomains and see if we can find one. I'm going to tell it to do it for about 30 seconds, see if we can find anything. And now if this doesn't work, then there's other tools that we can use. You see we have a mail and we have contracts. Now we're looking for the name of a recruiting officer, so I'm guessing that contracts is probably the one that we want to look at. But let's see what else we can come up with. Mail could also be a possibility, but I think contracts is probably our best bet. Let it finish running. Now, one thing you want to do is that I usually keep a notepad nearby in case I need to write things down or type them into another browser window. But what you can also do is you can also, I can click on this and Control C to copy it. So then when I go into my next tool, which is my host fingerprint tool,
information gathering module initiated.
I'll just have that domain on my clipboard. Now what the host fingerprint tool does is it looks at domains and it tries to find vulnerabilities on them. If you've done the tutorial missions, you already knew all this. But if you're just looking for information about the game, then this is what it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fingerprint contracts.militech.net. And what this tool does is it scans the server and looks for known vulnerabilities, weaknesses in the software that's running on the server. Takes about 20 seconds, I guess. As you can see that the Akami technology on this server is vulnerable. So what can we do with that information? Well, now we go to our exploit database tool.
Information gathering module initiated.
And we search for exploits, which is hacker speak for exploit, and we're looking for exploits we can use on that technology. And as you can see, we can use CVE Common Vulnerability 2008-1106. The management interface in the Akami client allows remote attackers, that's us, to bypass authentication through TCP/IP, etc., etc. The important information that we need right down here is the preferred delivery method, which is TCP/IP, and the exploit to use is content spoofing. And of course, our technology is Akami. So now we have a domain, contacts.militech.net, and we have a way to get in there. Now, fortunately, the National Security Agency has given us access to their wonderful tool called FoxAcid.
FoxAcid server connection initiated.
So we're going to. Now, the parameters on here, oops. The parameters on here, delivery is the method of delivery that we need to use, which, as you can see on our other tool, is TCP/IP. So I'm going to choose delivery, TCP/IP. And the exploit is content spoofing. So I'll choose content spoofing. And then the rootkit. You get new rootkits, I'm assuming, as you progress through the game. This is the only one that I, these are the only two I have available at the moment. After Midnight is the one that we want to use. Target URL, fortunately, it populates all that data for us. So now I have exploit, my vulnerability, and what we're targeting. So I just click on the red hand of
Fox
doom.
Acid attack launched.
The fox gets busy.
Fox acid attack successful.
And now we have access to this server, the militech.net contracts.server. So now I'm going to connect to the VPN.
Connection completed.
So now I'm connected. I don't need these tools anymore. I have all the information I need to get in there. So I'm looking for the name of the recruiting officer. So I'm going to do
information gathering module initiated.
This is the WMI scanner. This looks for different technologies that might be running on the server and the paths to them. Printers, Windows directories, stuff like that. Mapped hard drives, etc. So I run netscan, pretty simple, no parameters, just run netscan. We have a client database, contract archive, and active directory. Now, since I'm looking for a specific person, I'm going to look at archive directory, active directory, because that has vulnerabilities we can take care of. So network intrusion, information gathering, active directory.
Information gathering module. Initiated.
Just going to paste in this that we got from over here, Active Directory. If you're familiar with Windows administration, then you're very aware of Windows Active Directory. Oh, there we go. So now we're in. We have the Active Directory. So we're looking for a person. These are the different types of objects you can have on Windows Directory, but we're looking for... So we're looking for an officer, so we're probably looking for administration. So we have Nasir Ghazi Issa, who is a recruiter. It's a possibility. Let's see who this other guy is. The Houston chief recruiter, Devin M. Houston. I believe this is the guy we're looking for. Unfortunately, we can't copy and paste this one. So we went Devin M. Houston. So I'm going to go back to the bounty screen. And I'm going to send the name of our to the DGSE. Now, as you see, there's other bounties over here. As far as I know, there's no penalty for not completing a bounty. You just simply don't get a reward. And you can see over here also that when I complete this bounty, if this is the right guy, I'm going to get some reputation. Now, sometimes, you know, there's many different many different intelligence agencies in the world. Sometimes, if you complete a mission for one agency, you'll get positive reputation for them, but then you might get negative reputation for another one. For instance, you might complete a mission for the United Kingdom, but then lose reputation with Germany, something like that. So you have to keep an eye on these things. So I'm going to go ahead and click on submit. And Devin M. Houston was our guy. So bing pot, we've got him. So now you were able to see some different tools that were available in Nite Team other than the social engineering toolkit, which is all I got to show you in the other video. Now, as I play more along the game, I'll be making more videos to show you other things. I'm not going to try and avoid showing any sort of spoilers for the main storyline though. So thanks for watching. Hit the like button or leave a comment and appreciate your visit.